Hey, this is Sky. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Let's talk about change. Change is a good thing. How do we change? How do people change? Change starts from within. I can't make you change. I wish I could. I wish I could just go around making people change. Oh, I would use that superpower, that evil power, and change every single person. I'd change every one of you. You wouldn't even know it. And I would change you all into something that I want. But that's, you know, that obviously can't happen. You have to change yourself. Your wife can't change you, no matter how much she bitches and nags at you. She can't change you. You can't change other people. You think, well, I'll change them, or I'll make them see things my way. You can't change people. That's why going into a relationship, you really have to get to know somebody and to be able to accept who they are and see if that fits in with who you are, because you're not changing that person. That's who they are. People change themselves. But how do we change? So you want to change yourself. How do you change? Well, that wanting to change is the first step. When you've made the choice to say, I want to change, you've already stepped into the arena. Now, you haven't already taken the steps to change, but you've made the step forward. You've jumped in that line. You see, not everybody wants to change. Some people, they may have an idea of what it would be like to be a different person, like a fantasy, but they don't want to take the steps to get there. So that's not really true change. You don't really want to change if you don't want to take the steps, even if the steps are uncomfortable. When you're really ready, the uncomfortable steps, it doesn't matter. When you're ready to go in for that operation, and it may be scary, and it's going to hurt, and the recovery is going to be a nightmare, it's going to be a drag, you can avoid that for most of your life. But when you're ready, when the pain is too much, when you can't take it anymore, and you're just like that, I have to do this, I can't take this anymore, then the process, the suffering that you go through, it's worth it. You see, you can't change what you're not disgusted by, or insulted by, or offended by. You have to be offended for change to happen. This is how change happens in society. Societal change happens because we get offended, we get disgusted, insulted by behavior, by laws, by politicians. And then when we get so disgusted by it, we collectively change it. You can think of lots of laws that are created this way. Within ourselves, we have to reach a point of extreme dissatisfaction. And this is how it worked for me. And I got to a point where I just didn't like who I was anymore. And I wasn't willing to go another day. Suffering is that type of person. I'm going to suffer anyways. And what direction do you want to suffer? Do you want to suffer forwards or backwards? And I realized I'd rather start suffering forwards. So, at the very least, sure, I'm a piece of shit. I'm a lowlife. I'm untrustworthy. I'm a terrible person. I'm evil. But I tried today. I tried my hardest today to get in shape, to eat right, to do the right thing, to be a good person, to think loving thoughts. I tried. That putting in that work to be able to go to bed at night with that knowledge. The world may hate you, but you at least tried. I mean, that's what it's all about. That's how you get a good night's sleep. So you have to be conscientious and be humble and to acknowledge the fact that you have problems, you have weaknesses, you can be stronger. And the areas that you find that are weak, You'll only truly be able to jump on those areas to strengthen them when you become disgusted by it. So when you become disgusted by yourself in the mirror, by your body, which I know what that's like, to be disgusted by my own body. Take all the mirrors out of the house. There's a long time I had no mirrors in the house. I don't want to see myself in the mirror. I'm too ugly. I don't like what I look like. When you get to a point like that, you don't lash out at the country, at the world, at society, at your community, your family, your friends. You don't lash out at them to try to force them to accept you and acknowledge you, which they might do, but that's not the point. Because that's not change. That's staying the loser that you are, that you're not happy with. That's why this whole idea of inclusivity based around victimhood and oppression and suffering, and you know, people have these body issues, and instead of working on it, they just want everybody else to accept them. Which is like if somebody who's depressed that comes to me, and I'm all about being strong, and they're depressed and they're weak, and they say, you have to accept my depression and my weakness, and I'm just gonna laugh and say, no. No, I'm not going to accept your depression and your weakness. I'm not accepting that. And you have to get to a point in your own self where you're not accepting it anymore. You're not tolerating it anymore. All your excuses are lies. You're lying to yourself with that bullshit. So you have to be insulted. You have to use that disgust, that shame, that insult, that frustration with yourself, and use that as your motivation and your drive to be better. I may have been a piece of shit my whole life, a liar, a cheat, a thief, crazy. I may have been just a lowlife my whole life. Maybe people watching this that know me are like, yeah, you have. But through realizing this and acknowledging this about myself, understanding that I have problems, I've been able to get on top of that and say, I'm not gonna go another day being that old person. That old person that I used to be, the piece of shit, would never have read a book. So I'm gonna read a fucking book. The person that I used to be would never have eaten healthy. I'm gonna go eat healthy, just to spite that motherfucker. Just to have a big middle finger to my past, to the past person I used to be. See this? I'm eating brown rice and fucking good food, lean chicken. You go have Five Guys McDonald's, you punk weak bitch. You disgust me. And every day, I'm disgusted by the past me. And I promise myself I'll never be that motherfucker again. And I have a lot of negative influence in my life, which I've tried to get rid of. But there's still people around that desperately want me to be that old version of myself. Some of you who watch this channel really want me to be the old version of myself because you get off on that. But I'm disgusted by that old person. That old person is dead. The old version of me is dead. I killed him. I murdered him like a ninja. Slit that motherfucker's throat, and I was happy when I did it too. I'm the only version of me that exists now. And it's a happily dissatisfied motherfucker who wakes up every single fucking day and says, you know what? I could handle more suffering to get rid of more weakness. I could be greater than I am. The weakness in me, when I find it, I get excited, but it disgusts me. And I use that disgust, like when you have a dirty house and you want to clean up, I go after that fucking dirt when I see it. So this is how you start change. This is how the change starts within you, is through that conscientiousness and that humble attitude of looking within, paying attention to your weaknesses, and instead of covering them up, instead of trying to force others to accept us for our weaknesses, we detach. With that detachment, you can see yourself for who you truly are. And when you become disgusted with your own behavior, insulted by your own existence because you're not living up to your potential. That doesn't mean you grab a gun and put a gun in your mouth. That's bitch shit. You're not running from your fucking problems. They will chase you to the next life. Your new mission is to stand up to yourself and to say, no way, man, I'm taking control. We're gonna do things differently now. Because I'm disgusted by the way that you handled shit. The way that you turned my life is insulting. So now I'm taking over. That's the new you. Hold on to that. It's all food for thought. Thanks for watching.